to him.
He's like, I don't want it anymore. I'm done. Let's be done.
Let's beat up some robots. Yeah, we'll do full tutorial. Why not?
In 2108, humanity began colonizing the stars. Their reach would eventually span a vast region of space known as the Inner Sphere. During its golden age, under the governance of the Star League, the Inner Sphere experienced unprecedented peace, prosperity, and technological advancement. But with a great rise comes a great fall. Beset by greed and mistrust, humanity splintered. The Star League crumpled. Technological advancement slowed. The great houses, each vying for supremacy, turned on one another, engaging in a series of conflicts known as the Succession Wars. Amidst this chaos, mercenaries became the proxy forces for the great houses. Numerous battlefields sprung up across the Inner Sphere, dominated by hulking war machines known as Battle Mechs. The year is now 3015, and these steel behemoths have become the tools of the mercenaries' trade. It's a lucrative time, yet one beset with perils of all kinds. Only the most skilled and brave among them will rise to become legend.
Captain Mason, please report to the hangar for testing. The Centurion is waiting for you.
I need to disable a joystick here. Obviously. Oh, that's why. It was leaning against my dam. There we go. We're good. I don't know why this game doesn't have VR. We're gonna get to pilot one of these fuckers. Battle mechs. Got no legs. Get up there. Nope.
Son, Fahad wants us to run the Centurion through its paces to see how it does. He spent months getting it operational again after we recovered it from that ruined factory on Ramen 2.
What a bloody shit all that place was. Hopefully nothing explodes during the test, mate. I'm pretty confident you won't need to eject. No promises though, eh?
He's joking, I think. Go on and power her up. Good. Fahad?
Yeah, bringing up the systems now. Okay, armor and structure display up. Weapon systems up. Tactical display up. Everything looks good to go.
Keep in mind there's parts on that mech that are at least 200 years old. So ease it forward slowly and we'll see how it goes. And don't forget to hit the brake once you're clear of the hangar.
Yes, we are playing with our HOTA.
Look at her go, eh? That's my girl. She's a beauty, ain't she?
Certainly is. Okay, engage reverse throttle and navigate into the waypoint I've set up. Use your tactical display to see where you're going.
Is it this one? I don't know what axis this is going to be. Say five.
Nice work. Now revert to your drone cam.
Hold on.
Let's go ahead and do a left-right rotation test.
I should be able to twist my throttle though. Why is that not There we go. Why'd that take so long to figure that out?
Okay, now let's make sure the torso is working properly. Try looking around in all directions. Good. As you can see, the torso rotates independently from the legs. Your direction of movement, therefore, may differ from the direction you're actually looking. If you check your tack screen, you can see your current leg orientation is represented by the dotted line, and your torso orientation is represented by the cone. Move your torso to the left or right, then try aligning your legs with the torso. Good. The mobility course is next. Show me a
What do we have mapped for center torso? I don't know which one it is. Got to right deep.
As you can get through those turns while still hitting each of the waypoints.
Nice.
Centurion was made to have a good balance between speed and firepower. All we have to do now is find out if the weapon systems work.
Oi, what do you mean if the weapons work? You know how long I spent stripping each one of those components and putting them back together again? They'll bloody well work, mate.
You heard the man. Let's go shoot some stuff. Follow me. You know, back when I was your age, I once slammed the hunchback I was piloting right into my instructor's javelin. Oh man, was he pissed.
Commander Mason?
Yeah, go ahead, Rihanna.
Thought you'd want to know that all repairs to the Leopard have been completed. We're now spaceworthy and ready to take on our next contract. How's the kid faring?
He's a natural, just like his old man.
I see humility is still in short supply, as usual. Just don't break that mech. We need it in full working order.
Systems are now online, gents. Be gentle, hey?
Always, my friend.
Yeah, right. That's a lot of bullocks, isn't it?
All right. I've mapped the autocannon to weapon group one. You're free to fire whenever you're ready. Shells in the middle of a firefight. It could be your last one. Lasers are mapped to weapon group two. Fire them when ready.
Half the fun is binding your fucking controls. Just me, or is this game gash?
That's good enough. Those lasers generate significant heat. You can see the temperature readout next to your armor and structure display. All weapons generate heat when fired. You overheat your mech during a firefight, and it could trigger a shutdown, so keep that in mind.
Offline.
Now for the fun stuff. Long-range missiles are set to weapon group 3. The target lock has been disabled for the moment, but never mind that. Just go ahead and fire at will. Don't track unless you have a target lock on something. Yep, they're as dumb as a post without it. Let's try targeting a drone first. Before you fire your LRMs.
I'm not going to enjoy this game if I can't play with my HODIS. But whatever, we'll figure it out. Just got to readjust all the sheeting posts.
Target acquired.
Makes a hell of a difference having that target lock, doesn't it? Next step is to test moving and firing at the same time. I've set up a series of aerial targets for you. Move through the aerial combat course as quickly as you can and shoot the drones down. I'll meet up with you on the other side.
Target.
By the barricade. Okay, I've projected three mechs, each with differing damage profiles. You should see them in the ravine below. Target the first one on your left. You can zoom in on the target for a more accurate shot, if you need to. Targeting and telemetry seem to be working. Note the center torso on that first mech. It's reading heavily damaged. Destroying the CT will destroy the mech no matter its relative condition. Go ahead and destroy the center torso. See that second mech? Both legs are heavily damaged. With one leg destroyed, mechs become easy targets. Both legs? It's over for them. Take out both legs. Is seriously damaged. It's a difficult shot to make, especially in the chaos of battle. But the fastest way to take out a mech is to eliminate the pilot. Go ahead and try shooting the cockpit. There you go. Now we're almost done. The battle simulation I've set up for you is the last hurdle. Follow me. You're gonna go head-to-head with an urban mech. They're slow and poorly armored. Perfect for this particular test. Should be a piece of cake for a pilot like you. Centurion seems fully fit and ready for battle. Let's head back. Back to the base. We'll buy Fahad a few beers to say thanks. Yeah, of course, we'll have to listen to him gripe about how rough we are on his battle mix. Small price to pay, I suppose, for having one of the best mechanics in the entire Inner Sphere.
I'm at the rendezvous point, but our contact isn't here. You see anyone, son?
The salvage crates at the last checkpoint were empty. Something's up if they're missing payments.
This is Commander Mason of Major Campbell. Make a note. Looks like someone is gonna need a lesson in paying their bills on time.
That's odd. What the hell?
Commander Mason, I repeat, a massive invasion force.
Acknowledge. I have a visual.
It's planet-wide, sir. We're evacuating.
We need to take what we have and go. The fastest way is across the swamp.
Commander. Sorry to wake you, but our sitrep has changed. Head to the bridge as soon as possible.
Commander, good to see you up. We haven't really had a chance to speak since your father was killed.
Well, I guess that cutscene that I somehow skipped by touching my mouse.
He was a good man. Hell, he sacrificed his life to save ours. I don't know what's going to happen next, but whatever it is, I'd like to be part of it. I'd like to stay on as your ops commander. That is, if you'll have me.
You kidding me? Your family, Rihanna, are as close as I have now. Besides, I'm going to need you.
Yes, I suspect you will. About our sitrep, it's not great news. Those bastards that came after us are in the process of setting up a blockade of the system, which means we're going to be trapped here with a tightening noose around our necks unless we do something about it.
Who are these guys?
Another mercenary outfit, by the looks of it. I don't know more than that at the moment.
Oh, here, it strikes me here. But as soon as I go over here, she loses me.
First things first, we need transport out of the system. That means a jump ship. I sent out a transmission right after the attack through the HPG. The message was for a longtime client of your father's.
And an old friend of mine. Name is Spears. He has powerful connections. I'm hoping he can help us out. Until I hear back from him, there's nothing we can do except lay low. In the meantime, Fahad wants to see you down in the hangar. The Centurion needs repairs and he wants to discuss them with you. I'll let you know when I hear back from Spears.
Copy that.
Hey, mate. Figured you'd want an update on the Centurion. Took a bloody beating back there, so fair warning. It's gonna be a while before she's operational again. Means you're gonna have to get comfortable with a light mech over in Bay 1 for now. She's a good girl. Won't let you down, you treat her right.
I'll do my best.
Yeah, heard that before. Anyways, you know the drill. Access the repair terminal here. Once you're done, I'll get started on the work, eh?
Repairing your mech. There are two ways to repair all damaged armor structure to mech. The first paramech button on the battle mech screen. Is wait, click loadout on the next screen, you all button, and then start work. Okay, that's fine. That's how we. Yeah, I know that routine. You want me to take a javelin? Are you kidding me? Oh, for God's sakes. That'll work. Four medium lasers. All right. Okay, well, I can't buy anything. Nothing for sale. Anything needs to be done. That's what I gotta do. Do work order. Let's paint your mech again. Not happy with it. Gotta go down there to repair my mech. Kill some time. At least there she is. Oh, I had to go down there because you wouldn't let me use this here.
Hey, Commander. I've received a transmission from Spears in response to my request for help. Take a listen.
Rihanna, I received your message. I'm sorry to hear about Nikolai. He was a good man and an even better pilot. He'll be sorely missed. I assume his son will be taking over the operation. Nikolai was always bragging about the boy's skills. Well, I hope he was right. I've begun working on a plan to get you safe passage out of the system, but it's going to take a little time. I expect you already know by now that whoever attacked you has set up a blockade to prevent your escape. It's a large system, though, so we can use that to our advantage. As soon as you receive this, I
okay,
want
this
you to
represents
the outermost
each of my four mechs. I'm guessing I can
it's
only have
than
four, maybe?
Device with a few leftover mining operations on it. There's an abandoned power station there. Now, I've got it on good authority that local raiders are using it as a secret cache for their ill-gotten goods. I know you can use supplies and materials for your repairs, and I expect you'll find what you need at that location. I've attached the exact coordinates to this message. Once I have a proper plan in place, I'll contact you again. For now, be safe.
All right, time to suit up, Commander. I've already input the coordinates. All I need is for you to sign off and get us there.
Understood.
On good authority, glacial ice, visibility is poor, battle area is 20 kilometers square, difficulty 5, duration 10 days. Okay, let's see what goes.
I'm sure you wish the Centurion was repaired and ready to go. For this particular mission, though, the Javelin is the mech best suited for the job. And hey, it has jump jets. They could come in handy.
Good try, Rihanna, but I'd still rather have the Centurion.
Well, can't blame a girl for trying.
Jet fuel low. Jump jet fuel empty.
F.
station being used by these raiders is derelict, Commander. But you can bet its perimeter defenses won't be. My guess? The raiders will have turrets stationed around the perimeter. If that's the case, it means they must have a generator close by. Find and destroy that generator before assaulting the plant, and you'll have a much easier time of it.
Got it. Thanks.
Heads up, Commander. I'm detecting enemy units up ahead. Could be a raider patrol.
Copy.
Target destroyed. Target acquired. Target destroyed. Target acquired.
Destroy them if you can.
acquired. Target destroyed.
Asset, move up to it, and we'll begin the recovery procedure.
Target destroyed.
Okay, got it. Keep looking.
Acquired.
Hey, where am I supposed to go now?
fuel low. Jump jet fuel empty. Jump jet fuel empty.
Because I blew up the one fucking crate.
Understood.
Your AI is dumb. Your AI is dumb.
To recover the materials we needed from that raider cache, and Fahad has already started the repairs to the Leopard and Centurion. You've made him a very happy man, though I doubt he'll admit it.
Hey, boss mate, that was quite the haul you brought back. Gonna make the repairs a bit easier now. But don't go getting stars in your eyes or nothing. I'm overworked as it is, and this ship needs a lot of loving, eh? So your Centurion is still gonna take plenty of time to fix. But yeah, like I said, nice job out there. Your old man would be proud. Now if there's nothing else gonna get back at it, all right, lot of work to do. Story of my life.
Good work with those raiders, Commander. While you were planet-side, I got word from Spears about the plan he's put in place for us. Take a listen.
Rihanna, Commander, good news. I think I can get you safely past the blockade with the aid of a local mining company. To make everything work, I'm gonna have to find you guys a recycled mercenary identification number. A new identity, essentially. Nick's Cavaliers, for all intents and purposes, no longer exists. I'll match that number to a new name of your choosing once the time comes. So, think about what you want to call yourselves. While I arrange that, you're gonna have to do a little work for the mining company in exchange for their cooperation. Things go well, they've agreed to hire you to transport some precious cargo out of the system, aboard an inbound jump ship. Using the new mercenary ID and with a legitimate contract in hand, you should have no problem slipping through the blockade. I've attached the particulars to this message. I'll be in touch once you've completed the mission. Good luck.
I already reviewed the information Spears sent. The mission is a straight-up protect and defend op. Seems these raiders have been harassing the mining company, among others. Stealing from them, extorting them, killing innocent civilians when their demands weren't met. I've uploaded the pertinent details into the mission briefing, so I won't repeat them here. You're good to launch any time, Commander.
Roger that. I'll see you on the other side.
Weather's really kicking up, Commander. Your visibility will be limited out there. Keep a sharp lookout for enemy units on your approach to that settlement.
Copy that.
Jump jet fuel low. Jump jet fuel empty.
Children here.
Rihanna, something's interfering with my sensors.
I think the raiders have set up some sort of jamming device nearby. I'll see if I can locate it.
Target destroyed. Target acquired. Target destroyed. Target destroyed. Acquired.
is taking significant damage. You need to clear out these raiders, now! Just yet. They're headed for the company's main processing facility on the other side of the mountain. You need to get there and thwart that attack, Commander.
Understood.
Jump jet fuel empty.
My sensors are getting worse.
The jamming device the raider set up is at the top of this path, Commander. You're going to have to manage as best you can until you're able to take it out.
Target destroyed. Target acquired.
Okay. With that jamming device eliminated, your sensors should have cleared up.
Yeah, much better.
Your onboard radar should also be operational now. You'll be able to detect enemies at a significant distance. Just in time, too. That mining facility is getting hit hard, Commander.
Target acquired. Acquired.
Attention, Commander. That vehicle is a piece of heavy machinery with tons of firepower. If left unchecked, it will do a lot of damage to the settlement. You should prioritize taking it out over the smaller enemies.
Acquired.
Good work, Commander. That should make the mining company happy. Prepare for exfil. I'm on my way.
Commander, it turns out the bastards who attacked us and who have set up the blockade are a mercenary outfit by the name of Black Inferno. Unfortunately, that's about all we know at the moment. Spears and I will try to dig up more information. Inferno forces are closing in. The company wants us to take down the raiders for good. I've detailed the mission briefing and it's...
Roger that.
thieves, Commander. Don't show them any mercy.
Mess with the bull, you get the horns.
That's it, exactly. I've got enemy contacts up ahead, Commander. They must have detected us on the way in. To the ground, Commander. finish destroying that base, Commander. To the extraction zone.
Roger that.
Your position very fast. When you see it, get a sensor lock on the target.
Copy that.
Remember your combat training, Commander. Enemies will have a harder time hitting you if you keep your mech moving. I advise you to stay mobile and keep to longer ranges.
Target destroyed.
Looks like these raiders somehow got their hands on a spider mech. It's fast, but lightly armored. Avoid letting it get behind you. That spider is a slippery one. What it lacks in offensive capabilities, it makes up for with speed and agility. A deadly combination if it gets into your blind spots. This one seems to have pre-existing damage on its right leg. If you're having trouble hitting the critical areas, try fire there instead. You may be able to wipe out its mobility advantage.
Point, and I'll pick you up.